أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهديه واستنى بسنته واقتفى أثره إلى يوم الدين. Dear brothers and sisters, those who were pilgrims, Hajj, who came back to London, Allah blessed you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted you Hajj this year. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. The challenge now, how to maintain these blessings, how to plan for my life. We have to be careful. Alhamdulillah, we are pure. We earn lots of hasanat. But be careful, shaitan is still there. Lots of people, they earn lots of rewards, as we mentioned this last session, but they are losing. And we said this is business. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. There is tijara, there is business. And Allah guide us to the best business, to have business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this business will give us the success here in this dunya and in the hereafter. The main target, tijara lan tabur. This business never get lost. Never, you never lose in this. When you have tijara with Allah, you will never lose. Who is the loser? Who is the bankrupt? As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked this question to Sahaba, do you know who is the bankrupt? He said, Ya Rasulullah, the one who lost his money. So he was rich, and sudden, like the credit crunch, he lost his wealth. He's a bankrupt. He said, no. The bankrupt person from my ummah, Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the one who will come on the day of judgment with lots of rewards, mountains of rewards. He done many hajj, fast, lots of ibad, nafl, sadaqat, charities, reciting many khatma and salah, nafl, tahajjud, lots of ibadat, lots of rewards. Smiling. Yes, sudden he'll find himself bankrupt. How this? He said he will find queues, lots of people waiting for him. He insulted this man. He assaulted this one. He consumed the money of his sister, his auntie, the inheritance. He backbite this. He swear at that. Everyone standing said, give me my right. I don't have money. Yeah, give me from your rewards. فَيَأْخُذُ هَذَا مِنْ حَسَنَاتِهِ وَهَذَا مِنْ حَسَنَاتِهِ. Everyone will get from his rewards until his rewards finished. All this huge rewards finished. Still some people waiting. Where is my right? I don't have more hasanat. No problem, take from our sins. Then Rasulullah ﷺ said, after that, he will get sins from others and he will be dragged to Jahannam. He's a big loser. Don't think, yes, I earn lots of hasanat. It's very good. The main challenge, how to maintain this hasanat, how to make sure you don't lose. Imagine someone, for example, a taxi driver, whatever, any mini cab, he said, today I have a journey. This, how much you're going to earn? £100. That's very good. But on the way, one ticket, speed ticket, another ticket. Oh, he earned, few tickets, 1, 2, 3. That means now he become loser. He's getting from his journey £100, but he's going to pay 2 tickets, 130 or 150. Hey, now he's a loser. Same. I pray, alhamdulillah, I got some. But when I finish my prayers, I start to talk back by someone. Remember this one, he will come on the day of judgment. He might take all rewards of these prayers and other prayers as well. Be careful. Be careful, please. The second point is what? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day, he said to Sahaba, I missed my beloved brothers. Then Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, we are here next to you. He said, no, you are ashabi. You are my companions. My beloved brothers, I didn't see them. They will not see me. They will come later, after a few centuries after me, like our generation. They didn't see me, but they have seen the sunnah of Rasulullah. And those people are blessed and follow the sunnah of the Prophet. He said, those people, ajr al-amil minhum, the hard-working person, that man who is not in the time of the Prophet, ajr al-amil minhum, the one who's be hard-working, good, obedient, he will be rewarded as 50 of you sahaba. In another narration, 70 of you sahaba. He said, ya Rasulullah, he will be rewarded as much as 50 of them. He said, no, 50 of you. لأنكم تجدون على الحق أعوانا, because the environment of Sahaba is supportive. You get some support. I'm next to you. Medina. Imagine that you are living in Medina in the time of the Prophet ﷺ. You have a house there in Medina. Who's the next neighbor? You come out in the morning. Assalamu alaikum. Who's my neighbor? Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Allahu Akbar. Who's the next neighbor? Umar ibn Khattab, Allahu Akbar. Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, Talha ibn Ubay, Ubaydillah, Zubayr ibn al-Awwam, 10 mubashirin bil Jannah. Many of Sahaba, they were granted Jannah. This is your neighbor. You go to the market. Who's the trader? Who's the businessman there? Uthman ibn Affan, Abdurrahman ibn Auf, Allahu Akbar. Zuhr time, do you? Who's giving adhan? Bilal, Allahu Akbar. You go to the mosque to pray. Who's leading salah? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Such environment like this, of course, supportive. You'll be perfect. But now in London, we are in fitna. You go out in fitna, at home in fitna, at work in fitna, everywhere fitna. So the good person, the good Muslim, the good obedient, who will be patient and hold on the deen, follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he will be rewarded like 50 of Sahaba. This is a challenge. 50 of Sahaba. So the good, I'm mentioning this example for what? Don't tell me I was perfect in Arafah. I was beautiful in Mina. I was very good in around the Kaaba. I was very good obedient, very good Muslim in Mecca. No. The hero, the good Muslim, the best obedient, who will challenge and will be a good obedient in London. اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حيثما كنت, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that, fear Allah wherever you are, whenever you are. Either you are in Ramadan or after Ramadan, you are in Mecca or in London, you are in Arafah, you are wherever you are, you should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should be hardworking, a good obedient. This is the hero, this is the good obedient. This is the one who will be rewarded as 50 of Sahaba. Why? Because he's a challenge. الغرباء طوبى للغرباء. Those people who will be as a stranger, he found himself stranger, but yet he is holding the deen, he followed the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he do his best, hard working to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam give you a glad tidings that you will be rewarded as 50 of Sahaba. So brothers and sisters, when you come back, you are in London, your challenge is how to be good obedient, how to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And every salah, say, I'm haji, I am pure, Allah has blessed me, forgive all my sins, I want my salah. And the best way is concentrate in Fatiha. Ulama said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed about 104 books. Conclude all of them in 3 books, Torah, Injil, Quran. Conclude these 3 messages in Quran. Conclude the whole message of Quran in Surah Al-Fatiha. And conclude Surah Al-Fatiha in Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in. Remember this surah when you said, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Allahu Akbar. You remember, Alhamdulillah. Allah bless me, Allah guide me, I am a Muslim. Allah guide me, Alhamdulillah, Allah bless me with Hajj. Allah guide me, I'm praying now. Alhamdulillah, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Whatever you need, all the favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. Allahu Akbar, the best 2 names, Rahman, Rahim. That's why Allah have the mercy with me. Allah bless me, Allah forgive all my sins. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawm al-Din, and this is the main target for me. I want someone to help me in the Day of Judgment. Who is the king? Who's on the Day of Judgment is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Maliki Yawm al-Din. That's why I said, Ya Allah, if you are Rabbil Alameen, if you are Rahman Rahim, if you are Malik Yawmiddin, so please, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Ya Allah, I want to be a good worshipper. I want to be a good obedient. I seek help from Allah. Ya Allah, I seek help to make me a good obedient. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. اهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ. Guide me to the straight path. صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. صِرَاط, the way of the prophets and the messengers and the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And save me from those who go astray, those who you get angry at them. Ya Allah, be pleased with me and guide me. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our heart firm with the deen until we die as Muslims. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. رَبَّنَا تَوَفَّنَا مُسْلِمِينَ وَأَلْحِقْنَا بِالصَّالِحِينَ. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.